Hello everyone, welcome to Electromagnetic Spectrum Lab YouTube channel. In this video I want to start a playlist for Quantum Optics Basics and Applications tutorial, which begins with an introduction to quantum well structures. At the beginning, heterojunction is defined as the junction between different semiconductor materials with different bandgap energies. So, heterostructures is formed from multiple heterojunctions and generally is categorized by superlattice and multi-quantum well structures. Multi-quantum well, or in short MQW, consists of several quantum wells. In an MQW system, it is assumed that there is no interaction between neighboring quantum wells because the barriers separating the wells are thick enough. A superlattice is formed from a periodic set of quantum wells, like MQW, in which the thickness of the energy barriers separating the individual wells is made sufficiently small. As the barrier becomes thinner, the electron wave function corresponding to the wells overlap due to the tunneling effect. As a consequence, the discrete energy levels of the wells broaden and produce minibands. A quantum well consists of one material usually with relative narrow bandgap energy sandwiched between two materials which are called barrier on either side with wider bandgap energy. MQW structures are applicable in optoelectronic devices, optical diode, and also optical modulators. Typically, quantum well structures use 3 and 5 semiconductor group like gallium arsenide or nitride semiconductor combinations such as gallium nitride and aluminum nitride. Due to confinement of electron in just one direction means growth axis of layers, electron has mobility in transverse direction. For example, in this figure, the electron wave vector has X and Y components. In this part, I am going to discuss about the band theory of quantum well briefly. Based on the de Broglie statement, a particle of momentum P has an associated wave of wavelength lambda as this equation, where H is the Planck constant. An electron in a vacuum at a position r and away from the influence of any electromagnetic potential could be described by a state function as psi, where k is the electron wave vector. Also, for an electron in a vacuum away from the influence of any electromagnetic fields, the total energy is just the kinetic energy as T parameters, which is described as this equation. Therefore, the dispersion on energy curves are parabolic as shown in this figure. So, after some manipulation, we can conclude that the equation describing the total energy of a particle in this wave description can be described as this relation, which is called the time-independent Schrödinger equation. It has been found from experiment that there are two distinct energy bands within semiconductors, included as valence and conduction bands. The lower band is almost full of electrons and can conduct by the movement of the empty states. This band originates from the valence electron states, which can constitute the covalent bonds holding the atoms together in the crystal. The empty states are occupied by holes, which holds rise to the uppermost point of the valence band. The upper band is almost devoid of electrons. It represents excited electron states which can be occupied by electrons promoted from localized covalent bonds into the extended states in the body of the crystal. Another important parameter which should be introduced is the energy band gap, which is defined as the energy between the valence and conduction bands. In band theory, there are two highlighted approximations. The first is the effective mass, and second is the envelope wavefunction approximation. The effective mass approximation states that as a crystal potential is complicated, it can approximate it by a constant due to simplicity. Then the Schrödinger equation can be derived from an electron in crystal by allowing the introduction of an empirical fitting parameter called the effective mass. In the envelope function approximation, two important points have been argued. The effective mass approximation is a valid description of bulk materials, and heterojunctions between dissimilar materials, both of which can be well represented by the effective mass approximation, and can be described by a material potential which derives from the difference in the band gap or conduction band edge. Once this is accepted, then the electronic structure can be represented by the simple one-dimensional Schrödinger equation. In this equation, Vz represented the band discontinuities at the heterojunction. The name of envelope function approximation derives from the deduction that physical properties can be derived from the slowly varying envelope function identified here as psi z. It has been shown that the original confined states within a one-dimensional potential broaden into subband, thus allowing a continuous range of carrier momenta. It is worth noting that subband is related to each electron energy level in conduction band or hole energy level in the valence band. So to find the distribution of energy and momenta of a particular number of electrons within a subband, we need a knowledge of the density of states, which means how many electrons can exist within a range of energies. At the first, it is necessary to understand this property in bulk crystals. As you see, the density of states for bulk crystal is calculated using this equation. Based on the equation and this figure, the density of states within a band and around a minimum where the energy can be represented as the parabolic function of momentum is a continuous function that is proportional to the square root of energy. Now, by using the exponent formulation, after some mathematical manipulation, we can obtain the density of states for two-dimensional system, means quantum well system, as this equation. My first tutorial of quantum optics and quantum well topic was finished. In next session, I will discuss about theoretical model of calculating electron wave function, various effects and phenomena, and other related topics of quantum well structures. Thank you for watching and have a good time.